I use calipers to measure small things around the shop all the time, but they're also really convenient as a sort of scratching marking gauge. But then I saw this thing advertised online, which is sort of a caliper scratching marking gauge. Possibly inspired by me? I don't know. And it's got a carbide tip, which of course does an excellent job of scratching. And that also works quite well on metal. And it can measure inside dimensions in metric because this roller and this pin add up to exactly 10 millimeters. But I also use my calipers to set the table saw fence like this. But this thing doesn't do that because it doesn't have anything that sticks out the bottom. And this thing has got some very sharp corners on here that kind of hurt the thumb, but that's easy enough to fix. That feels much better. Now the first time I ordered this, I ordered it off of AliExpress and there was a really good price. And then a couple of weeks later, arrives this thing here. A spare scribe for one of these things because AliExpress has always been kind of sneaky that way, and the color selection on AliExpress was actually for the scribe. That's why the price was so good. So I was kind of annoyed and I ordered it again, and a month later it's like, why hasn't it arrived? And I checked and they canceled my order! So annoying. So I ordered it again at twice the price off of Amazon and it came promptly. And it came in this holster without the scribe in here, but two scribes in this little side pocket. And then I realized spare scribes for these calipers is a thing, because if you drop them and it falls on the carbide bit, that's going to break. And then I realized maybe this thing is not ideal for me because I end up pushing my calipers accidentally off the workbench quite a lot. No good calipers were hurt in the making of this video. So I thought maybe I could optimize regular calipers to be better at scribing, except not these ones because these are my favorites. So I bought these ones really cheap off of AliExpress. They only cost $13 Canadian. And they measure accurately enough, but they don't slide super smooth. Just listen to the sound of that compared to these ones. And the reason is this is smoother on here, whereas here it just looks like it might have been cut with a water jet or something. But again, works well enough. So my thinking is to cut the bottom jaw right here so I'm down to the square part of it here and I can round it a bit so it slides better. And cut the top jaw a bit shorter so that I can scratch better with it like that. So this is going to be a point in there and this is still under a square. And cut that to a point here so it scores nicely and I still have the inside measuring capability. And I can still measure outside just by measuring further up on the jaws. So I just need to get this off of here, which means removing this bit here. And this bit here is loose on there, and I tried tightening that earlier, but it turns out the screws on here are either not threaded properly or cross-threaded. So the reason these aren't tightened all the way down is because they can't be tightened all the way down. But right now, I just want to take that part off anyways. Ah, that's the cross-threaded one. There we go. And given that these are sacrificial calipers and for the price, I really don't mind the quality shortcomings, because again, they actually do measure accurately. And I just noticed how they attached this part here. They kind of tapered it down, inserted it into a slot, bent it over it, and whacked it next to there with a cold chisel to pinch it in there, but I guess it works. Well, that slides a bit better now. Well, I managed to fully use up that disc without breaking it. The key to not breaking Dremel cutoff discs is to have a very steady hand. And to help with that, never hold it just freehand in the air. Always have your hand resting on something so that if it binds a little bit, it doesn't move out of control. Also, unchuck the disc as soon as you're done cutting. And I also rounded all the outside edges that aren't used for measuring because it just so much improves how the calipers feel in the hand. And it still goes to zero when I close it and measures these scribe tips at 2 millimeters, which is correct. And let's see, this is almost 50 millimeters, so half of that is wee bit under 25. That might be two lines, so maybe I didn't do that quite right. The problem is it does scratch a little bit off center because it's flat on one side. So set it to 25. Oh, now I'm outside. But I think this works well enough, and it scribes fairly well, slides nicely. Slides better than these slide. And I managed to screw this little bit all the way on. I examined it, and it turns out one of the holes wasn't tapped all the way through, so I just counterboard it to cut away the unthreaded part of the hole, and now it's on there flush. Now it turns out the inside measurement on this thing is about 0.2 millimeters low, so I'm just going to grind these things back a little bit. And now it reads 0.12 high at the very tips, better further back. I just ground away too much. Whoops. This would all be so much more complicated if I was a machinist. Well, that's a bit better. So I'll have to see if I like using these as my new shop calipers, and despite the quality of the raw material, I bought another pair because they're so much nicer to use at my desk than a set of plastic calipers. And these ones I'll save for metalworking because they can scribe hard material with a carbide scribe, and that way hopefully I won't drop it so much.